gentlemen. Good afternoon, one and all. Can I just start off by checking a few items with you? First of all, can you pop your phones on silent or switch them off, please? And just before we getting the ceremony, just a reminder from our happy couple that today's ceremony piece is unplugged. So please keep your phones away and no posting on social media, please, until you've seen that Caitlin and Jono have done that first. But can I just double check? Can I ask you to pop your hands in there if you're on the groom's side of the family?
Oh.
There you go, didn't know. And bride side? Brilliant. And now pop your hands in the air if you're a plus one and you haven't got a clue. Oh, that's worrying. Okay, ladies and gents, without further ado, can I ask you, if you're able, to please stand, because it's time to receive the wedding party. Please be seated. Well, good afternoon, everyone. My name is George McLean, and I'm a Humanist Marriage Officer with the Fuse Foundation. And I'm going to find it pretty hard today to follow those flower men, I'm sure you mean. But it is a real privilege for me today to be conducting Caitlin and Jono's wedding ceremony for them. I'm truly honoured they asked me to officiate for them, so thank you both. So here we all are in the beautiful surroundings of the Crutherland Hotel. And I welcome you here today to witness and share in the joy of the marriage of Caitlin McGurk and Jono Olejnik. It means so much to them both that you're all here today to witness the commitment they're making to each other. By simply being here, each of you are playing a special part in today's ceremony, but none more so than our wedding party. So on Team Caitlin, we have Maid of Honour Sinead and Bridesmaid Nadine. And on Team Jono, we have Best Man Anthony and Groomsmen Richie and Scott. And as we seen earlier, making a very special appearance, our flower men Peter and Daniel. Also included in today's ceremony, we'll have poems and readings from Caitlin's brothers, Aidan and Martin. Now, of course, in many cultures, including our own, it's long been since the tradition for the bride to be given away. Now, I know that, Jono, you're not here to claim any ownership of Caitlin. Well, at least I hope you're not. Nor, Chick, you're here not to give any away. But, Chick, I would like to ask you to stand again for a second so I can ask you this very important question. Chick, do you give Caitlin's hand in marriage to Jono, entrusting her in his love and care from this day forth?
Yes.
Today's ceremony is humanist in nature, so provides Caitlin and Jono the freedom to express their relationship in their way. Humanism is an ethical life stance about respecting and caring for one another and the world in which we live in. So as such, it's about the things in life that bring us all together, like today, rather than the things that divide us. I feel sure that whatever your own personal beliefs are, that you'll find this wedding ceremony for Jono and Caitlin to be dignified, sincere and meaningful. Now, marriage joins two people who trust the love that they have found. Today, Caitlin and Jono will make a formal acknowledgement before you all that they want to spend the rest of their lives together. Their marriage will be a true partnership, with each understanding the importance of developing in their own ways as individuals, and at the same time, growing together as a couple and sharing one future. It's clear already, of course, that Caitlin and Jono already trust that love they found. And as a little reminder of their life milestones, I'm going to be sharing with you, just a little while, their love story with you all. But before we do that, and as an official starter to today's ceremony, I'd like to invite Caitlin's brother Aidan to front and centre to join us to recite a lovely wedding speech.
Thank you, George.
Oh, sorry.
Your big day is finally here, my dear and lovely sis, for this is something special I surely would not miss. It is an honour and a privilege to be standing by your side. I am proud to say my sister is a beautiful blushing bride. You have been a huge part of my life, and now I stand beside you as you become a wife. I wish you a life full of happiness, love and more. Best of luck to you and the man who you adore. Thank you.
I would now like to share you our Happy Couples love story journey. And it begins, of course, 9 years ago, during a summer working holiday in Malia. There was a groom here who was to play the knight in shining armour to his future wife. He just didn't know that part at the time. Caitlin and our friends were working at a beach bar where Jono and his friends arrived as they were getting fired. They got talking, and before they knew it, Jono here offered them jobs at the bar that they were working at. It was to be the start of that classic summer holiday romance, which all kicked off with a first date to an abandoned port, jumping off rocks into the sea, and included beers, pizza, playing pool, and topped off back at Jono's by watching episodes of Towie. Jono's Towie obsession, of course, is fueled by his own personal appearance, I'm told, on the show as an extra one time, which I'm pretty sure all of you on his side know all the time about this. It was soon time, though, to travel back home, they told me, bringing their summer romance to an end. But they knew they just couldn't be apart. It wasn't an option. So a little while later, Jono took matters into his own hands, booked a cheap flight to Scotland, and basically never left. I guess, as they say, the rest is history. As 1 week became 2 weeks became a month, and so on and so on. Caitlin continued her studies at university, and this was all well. Jono, fueled by that adventurous side, remember, got a job swinging through the trees in Goake, Aberfoyle, swearing blind to Caitlin he was actually going to work each day. Caitlin was so scared, I'm told, to tell her mum that her and Jono were living in sin. So she told Veronica a wee white lie about her friend going overseas for 12 months and giving them their place to stay in for free as an offer they could not refuse. But Veronica, I'm pretty sure you've seen right through that one. It really is fair to say from that moment that both Caitlin and Jono's loved ones, all of you here, from the very start, have welcomed them both into your families and friendships with love and open arms. And they've supported them through their summer romance to their Australian dream and everything in between, including today, of course, their big day. Now, that Australian dream started when they left to travel to Thailand, Cambodia and Australia in 2017. They love travelling, we all know that, and have also managed visits to Paris, Singapore, Dubai and New Zealand. But it's fair to say that their 5-year Oz adventures so far have caught their imagination, causing them to lay down roots on the Gold Coast. In some ways, arranging their wedding from thousands of miles away has been easy, with their day jobs in marketing, events and tour planning playing a healthy part. But I do have to mention Caitlin's mum on this occasion, because I know, Veronica, you've been their eyes and ears on the ground. Is that right, Caitlin and Jono? Yes. Let's hear it for Caitlin's mum. Jono was soon thinking about his engagement proposal to Caitlin and had big ideas for it to happen during their initial 1-year working adventure trip. He had the ring and wanted to propose on Christmas Day in Thailand. The romance soon faded, I have to say, with that idea, mostly down to an 18-bed hostel, the consumption of vodka Red Bull buckets. Somehow, the moment just didn't. But Jono was then to keep hold of the ring, searching for that moment in time, that precious moment. 3 years later, you're a fast actor, John. It was to be a holiday trip to the Amalfi Coast whilst en route home to surprise Veronica on her 50th birthday celebrations. Thirtieth. Jono snuck off to arrange a private sunset boat trip with Caitlin none the wiser about what was about to happen. He managed to call Chick, you may remember, for permission, and he was over the moon and asked Jono if he could maybe just hold off till they get to the local pub though instead. But after hearing his plans, he gave him the thumbs up. So as the sun was setting out on the sea on Amalfi Coast on the boat trip, Jono finally found his moment, dropped to one knee and asked Caitlin to become his wife. They have done many amazing things, of course, living abroad in Australia, such as skydiving, hot air ballooning, swimming with whales and even sharks, but the adrenaline and the rush from that engagement moment simply beats them all. Of course, today, their wedding day, is about to challenge that one, of course. Maybe it will equal it just the same. And it does really does mean the most to them all. They asked me to say that you are all here today and made a special effort, how near or however far you've travelled to be with our newlyweds. So, that's us bang up to date with our happy couple story. And I know that you're as delighted as they are that we are all here today to help celebrate not only their marriage and their union together, but we're all here to write the next chapter in their love story. So enjoy yourselves today and let's hear it for our happy couple! Okay, and to continue with today's ceremony, I'm now going to invite Caitlin's other brother, Martin, forward to recite our second poem of today.
So yes, here's to a future that is bright, warm and clear. But more than that, here's to right now and what it means to be here.
Start again.
Cut that bit out, Gary.
Gary, we'll start again.
Start again.
Many Jacob bombs have you had?
No, enough.
You're surrounded by your loved ones and all are wishing you well as you create a brand new chapter in the story that's yours to tell. You talk about the memories you have yet to make together and the moments you've already shared to be carried with you forever. But take the time to live today as your marriage begins. Look around and soak it up the moment you're in. For this is where the magic starts. When you say your vows, you pledge to spend your lives as one because of the love you feel now. So yes, here's to a future that's bright and warm and clear. But more than that, here's to right now and what it means to be here. Well.
Now, during their time together, Jono and Caitlin have come to understand, respect and love each other dearly. So I asked them independently and in secret to first of all tell me three reasons why they loved each other. I also asked them for a fourth reason, and that's the one thing that drives them mad about each other. So ladies and gents, for the first time, I'm now going to reveal their answers. So Caitlin, first of all, Jono told me these three reasons why he loves you. Reason number one, I love Caitlin, is because she's my partner in crime. I love how we are still addicted to each other through our travels and experiences together. Reason number two is I love that she supports all my crazy ideas, ambitions, goals, and takes the time to let me just go with it and become the best version of me. And reason number three is I absolutely love our weekends when we just wake up, go out for a walk, go for coffee. We want the same things in life and share the same goals for the future. We're even so close, she even picks up my smelly socks. But the one thing, a part of the drives John Old mad is that Caitlin's brain constantly works in the future. It drives me mad. As soon as we awake sometimes, she's asking me what I want for dinner. And dinner the rest of the week. And dinner the following week as well. And even before this trip, I'm told, Caitlin, you were trying to plan a picnic in Scotland when you hadn't even left Australia yet. And to you, John. Okay. Reason number one why Caitlin loves you. I love that John O pushes me to be the best version of me every day, and he knows me inside and out. He always knows what's best, and annoyingly, he's always late. Reason number two is I love that John O is the calm to my crazy. He definitely keeps me sane in our relationship. And reason number three is that after all this time, I still love that Joro can make me smile and belly laugh every single day. He's the funniest person that I know.
So sore.
But this may not be a surprise to you this time. What drives me crazy is when he gets home, he takes off his socks and leaves them under the coffee table and piles them up. Let's hear it for their honesty. You better sit them round, I think.
Laura, sorry. Laura's going to come and find
out. Yeah, move on then.
Laura's been adopted.
It's really silent in here.
Laura's
going to
put his socks up.
Thank you.
Joro are now going to take part in a traditional Scottish hand fasting symbolic gesture. Hand fasting is an ancient Celtic marriage ritual, and if you've ever wondered where the expression tying the knot came from, well, now you know. It is a symbolic way of showing that you'll be joined together for the rest of your life. Representing Caitlin will be a cut of the Dalgleish tartan, and representing Jono will be a cut of the Murray of Elibank ancient tartan. I am about to wrap these tartans around their joined hands as a way of confirming their union. Now, Caitlin and Jono, being a very modern couple of course, have added a modern twist to this ancient gesture, because they're going to first of all take a shot, then tie the knot. So can I ask you to join your right hands together, please? So first of all, this piece of tartan is here to represent Caitlin's love for John. And this piece of tartan represents Jono's love for Kate.
Tie as tight as you can.
It's alright, Chick, you're not getting her back, sorry. Now, today we have a shot of Tequila Rose and Fireball.
Very Scottish.
These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build a future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years. These are the hands that will give you strength and support when you need it. And these are the hands that will hold yours with these shot glasses as I say, 3, 2, 1, go! Hey! Somewhere that's... Just about going there. Yeah, thank you. So we now move on to the most important part of today's ceremony, of course, where Caitlin and Jonna will exchange wedding rings and legal vows of commitment. Your wedding rings will stand as a permanent reminder of the vows you're about to exchange today. So wear them always. And when you look down at them, think about the happiness you both felt on this, your wedding day. So, can I ask Anthony to please join us? And can I ask you, do you have the ring, sir?
No, I can't. Dad. Have you got it, seriously?
Hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Just hold, stand back, hold back, just get you ready. So, first of all, Jono, these are your legal vows of commitment to Caitlin. So, you both... come back closer and hold hands. Repeat each sentence after me. I, Jono Olejnik, sincerely declare.
I, Jono Olejnik, sincerely declare.
That I accept you, Caitlin McGurk.
That I accept you, Caitlin McGurk.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
Thank you. So, Anthony, can we have Caitlin's ring first of all, please?
No, the other one, sorry.
Jono, please place the ring halfway.
Like that.
And answer I do to the following question. Jono, do you give Caitlin this ring as a symbol of your love?
Oh, he's changed his mind. Wait,
commitment.
Sweating.
His hand.
Okay. Jono.
Yes.
Do you give Caitlin this ring as a symbol of your love, commitment and affection for her, and do you promise to always be there for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Please push the ring all the way.
Fantastic.
Caitlin, these are now your legal vows of commitment. Please both hold hands. Repeat each sentence after me. I, Caitlin McGurk, sincerely declare.
I, Caitlin McGurk, sincerely declare.
That I accept you, Jono Olejnik.
That I accept you, Jono Olejnik.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
Thank you. And Anthony, can we have Jono's ring, please? Okay. Thank you. Caitlin, push the ring halfway and answer I do to the following question. Caitlin, do you give Jono this ring as a symbol of your love, commitment and affection for him? And do you always promise to be there for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Just push the ring all the way. You have both now pledged your love, respect and commitment to each other. You have promised to stand by each other through the joys or sorrows that may lie ahead for both of you in your lives. So, following the declarations made before me and in the presence of these witnesses, it is now my very pleasant duty to pronounce you both husband and wife, Jono. We are now going to stop during the ceremony for a few moments to sign the official marriage schedule paperwork, and this will be witnessed by Sinead and Anthony. If I could ask everyone to please remain seated exactly where you are, and also enjoy and witness this very special part of today. Thank you all. a very special final act to today's ceremony. As we've seen, this wedding is not only about Jono and Caitlin, but a celebration of family. It is the blending of families, separate up until this moment, but united from this day forward, blending their different traditions and strengthening the family tree. Now, mothers cry when their children hurt and welcome pain and burden to give their sons and daughters the gift of life. Caitlin and Jono wish to honour this blending of families by presenting both of their mums and Caitlin's Nana Agnes a special gift to thank them for the many sacrifices that they've made and their unconditional love so freely given throughout their lives and, I know, in the future. So could we have the gifts, please, for a happy couple to present?
Sharon,
Caitlin,
Jono,
Caitlin,
Jono,
thank you. Thank you so much.
For being here to witness this very special occasion, and hope you enjoy the rest of today's celebrations into this evening. But to Caitlin and Jono, as you both embark on your marriage, and in the years to come, keep close in your hearts and in your minds the memories of today and the promises you've made to each other. And a warm and hearty congratulations from me.
Thank you so much.
But finally, ladies and gents, if you're able, can I ask you to once again please stand? And get ready to make as much noise as you possibly can, as it gives me the greatest pleasure to present to you for the very first time the new Mr. and Mrs.
Thank you.